Let's move over to our fridge now, this library, and take a closer look at it. In it, you'll find various, I'd call them drawers or categories to pick sounds from, or loops, or even whole kits. And as a general rule of thumb, you can memorize that on the very right-hand side, you have individual samples. And the further you go to the left, the bigger the things you load. So what I mean by that is here, there are individual one-shot sounds, single samples. Moving over to the left gives you loops, which is a collection of sounds, all stretching and syncing to your song tempo. If you go over here, this is the instruments category, and here you'll also find all your complete content or any kind of VST instruments that you have installed. So very, very big plugins with dozens of presets. And that's not all, because in Machine you find these sounds, which reference actually these sound slots over here. And there are hundreds of presets that you can pick from where you have a sample followed by a collection of plugins that are already set up so the sound has a good tone to work with. You find sometimes reverb and EQ plugins in here. So it's very, very cool to kickstart your project and just work directly with sounds instead of going to a sample and then working your way all up to where you want it to be. And lastly, there are groups. I mentioned them before. And they are a collection of 16 sounds that fit each other perfectly. So you'll find kits here in your library, and each of these kits are basically drum kits with additional sounds on top. And this is very like different from kit to kit, and it also differs a lot from genre to genre. So the one important thing that you need to keep in mind is that there is a little preview button down here. So once the speaker is active, you can hit any of the kits or samples and review them right away. More little but very important things that a lot of machine users don't even know about. It's this icon over here. This is called the user library. And once this little dude here is activated, it means that all of the icons over here now reference your user library. So your own sounds that you may have created over time when working with the machine. And you save the sound or an instrument or a loop, and then they show up here in your user library. So this is factory library and installed content from third-party manufacturers. And this here, boom, is your own user library with your own sounds. And especially if you load up projects, you just hit the user icon, then go to projects, and here's where all of them show up. There is a search bar that you can use here as well. If you're looking for a specific sound, let's go to one shots and I say like, I don't know, lo-fi, then all sounds will show up that have lo-fi either in their file name or somewhere in their tags inside. So this is really, really cool. Search bar is something that saves you a lot of time. In any other case, you can use these filters here to find a sound that you are looking for. Quick example, we're looking for drums. Go for claps. Here are some claps. And there's another list of characters that shows up here where I can pick vinyl claps or distorted claps, but yeah, let's go for the vinyl and listen to these. Show you one last thing here in the browser. It's called the Files browser, and this brings you to your actual hard disk, right? So if you have any folders that are not imported to the library yet, you can go here to the files browser. This gives you access to your hard disk, to your whole folder structure on it, and works essentially like an explorer or a finder